Welcome everyone. We are discussing this replication process of DNA. Here we have seen the first two steps, that is activation of the nucleotides, the first step, and the second step is opening of the DNA helix. So in activation of DNA nucleotides, phosphorylase is the enzyme which is helping in the activation of nucleotides, and in the second step, that is opening of DNA helix, two enzymes are there, that is helicase is the enzyme which is binding at the oricite. Oricite is nothing but a special nucleotide sequence will be there from where the DNA helix will open up. In prokaryotes there will be only one DNA helix, that is oricite, but in eukaryotes we have many oricites will be there. From where the DNA, from any one site, from any one oricite, the DNA starts to open up. Okay, so the enzyme which helps in opening up of DNA strand is helicase, and after opening up, to release the tension which will be there in the strand, so that it keeps straight. So that enzyme is topoisomerase, along with some single stranded proteins will be there. So with the help of this proteins, topoisomerase and helicase, the DNA strand will open up and stabilize. The DNA strand will open up and stabilize. A little strand will be open up. Now comes the third step, which is nothing but primer formation. The third step is primer formation. Now actually, what is primer? Primer is a set of RNA nucleotides. Primer is a small segment of RNA nucleotide. What is primer? This primer is nothing but it is small segment of RNA nucleotides. So like DNA shows polarity, RNA also shows polarity. So there is one free 5-carbon end and one free 3-carbon end, that is 3-carbon end and 5-carbon end will be there at one side, and on other side it will show 5' and 3'. So like DNA, RNA will also have polarity. But you first come here, coming to this, the third step, that is the primer formation. A primer is formed. Okay, a primer is nothing but small segment of RNA nucleotides. Small segment in the sense, some 7 to 10 nucleotides will join together and form a small segment. 7 to 10 RNA nucleotides, will join together and form a segment. So in this RNA, instead of thymine, we will be having uracil. Uracil will be there. Thymine will not be there. So a segment, that is small nucleotides, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 to 10 nucleotides will join together. This is 1, this is another, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5, this is 6, 7, 8. So 7 to 10 nucleotides, RNA nucleotides, will join together and form a segment. So this segment, this small segment, which consists of 7 to 10 RNA nucleotides, this segment is called as primer. So this is primer, which is nothing but RNA nucleotides, few RNA nucleotides joined together. I said you, DNA shows polarity, that is on the strand we have 1 3' and 5'. So on this antiparallel, so 3', 5', it will be, that is polarity will be there. At one end we have 3 3-carbon free, and the other end we have 5-carbon free. Okay, so if we see, if this is the end, here 5-carbon is free, means here at the end 3-carbon will be free. So this is the polarity. Like DNA shows polarity, RNA will also show polarity. This primer is nothing but RNA nucleotides joined together, few RNA nucleotides joined together. So as it shows, DNA shows polarity, this trimer, which is nothing but RNA, it also shows polarity. So here is the third carbon and here is the fifth carbon. At the start of the primer, at the start of the primer, at the first nucleotide, three carbon end will be. Suppose if third carbon end is free, then at the end of the 7 to 10 segments, for example, if we take 7 segments, I'll write here one more, draw it here one more. So this is the 7 segment. That is 7 nucleotides are joining together and forming a segment. So here what will be free? Fifth carbon will be free. Fifth carbon will be free. So now, an RNA, it will have functional group at the third carbon, OH functional group is there, and at the fifth carbon, phosphate group is there. I've already showed you the structure of nucleotide. At the first carbon, nitrogenous base will be there, and in RNA, at the second and the third carbon, functional group, that is OH functional group, will be there. So here, at the fifth carbon, where the fifth carbon is free, we have a phosphate here. Phosphate will be attached here. And at the third carbon, OH group will be there. At the third carbon, OH group will be there. So, in this, this is the primer. This is the primer. So, primer will be formed. How it will be formed? Small nucleotides, that is 7 to 8 nucleotides will join together and form a primer. After this, as soon as the DNA is opened up, when the DNA will be opening now, at the simultaneously RNA primer formation will take place. It will, as the DNA helix will open, there it will be, DNA will be opening, and here simultaneously primer will be formed. I already said you what is primer. So this is the sequence. It will be formed. First to this nucleotide it will be attached, second nucleotide will be attached, third nucleotide will be attached, fourth nucleotide it will be attached. So like this, a segment will be formed of 7 to 8 RNA nucleotides. So the third step will be the formation of primer. Primer will be formed. Okay, now after this primer is formed, why this primer is formed? So that to this primer, DNA nucleotides gets attached. So that to this primer, DNA nucleotides gets attached. Why there is need of RNA? Why DNA cannot? That is, here why DNA nucleotides need to be attached? Because we need to form a new strand. This is the parent strand. This has been opened up. So okay, and to this parent strand, which is acting as a template, one new strand has to be formed. At here also, and here also, one new strand has to be formed. Then only a copy will be made. Then only a copy will be made. This is the parent strand. These two are the parent strands. On these, so one will be, this will be acting as the template, and this will also be acting as the template. So both strands will be acting as the template. And on these template strands, now complementary strands will be form. So on this template, one complementary strand will be formed, and on this template also one complementary strand will be formed. So which strand? DNA strand. And for the formation of DNA strand, what we require is DNA nucleotides, because DNA is made up of nucleotides. So what we need is DNA nucleotides. So for the formation of this new strand, DNA nucleotides are required. DNA nucleotides are required. So DNA nucleotides has to be joined here. Then why this RNA primer is required? So when there is a join, when this bonds join, so what happens is there is as soon as the RNA primer is formed, the nucleotides will soon join together and make a long chain. Because so that bond between, when you see this one, between DNA nucleotides and DNA nucleotides, this is DNA and this is also DNA nucleotide. So this is RNA nucleotide and this is DNA nucleotide. So the time which is taken for the formation of bond between these two, so here that very less time is taken for the formation of bond between RNA nucleotide and DNA nucleotide when compared to this for bond formation between DNA nucleotide and DNA nucleotide. Okay, so instead of RNA nucleotide, if I take a sequence of DNA nucleotide also, so there will be a little more time will be required. Whereas if RNA nucleotides are taken, if primer is of RNA nucleotides, then within less time the bond will be formed and a new chain will be, new chain of nucleotides will be formed. So first reason why we take RNA nucleotides for primer formation is because the bond between DNA and RNA will be very eager, quick. The bond formation between DNA and RNA will be quick. And for attachment, for example, if we take an example, when we make a house, we use bricks and cement. So on this, now after we make a wall with the help of the brick and the cement, before we paint we put a primer. Why do we put the primer? Because it helps the wall and the paint to join together. So this is the wall, it is formed. On this wall, paint will be done. So before painting this wall, first we will be putting the primer. Suppose this is the wall and this is the paint. Paint should be there on this wall. But before we paint this, we paint this wall with primer. Then we paint it. So when we put the primer, now there will be, where that is the joint, the bond will be very strong, it will be bind easily. So this paint will bind to this wall easily with the help of this primer. You use this primer in your cosmetics. So before you apply foundation, you use primer or something so that it blends easily. So primer is used so that the binding will take place sooner and proper binding will take place. So that is why the third step is the formation of the primer. Okay, a nucleotide sequence will be formed. RNA nucleotide segment will be formed, which will act as the primer. Okay, this will act as the primer. As the primer, it has polarity, that is, third carbon will be free at one end, fifth carbon will be free at the other end. And to this, on this third carbon, we have a functional group OH. And on this fifth carbon, we have a phosphate link. So this is the primer. So what happens is, onto this primer, new DNA nucleotides will come and bind. New DNA nucleotides will come and join. This is the phosphate group. So this is the DNA nucleotide. So it will also have third carbon free and fifth carbon free. So this, at this third carbon of this RNA primer, we have an OH group, and this DNA nucleotide. So this is the fifth carbon is free here. So a bond is formed between third carbon of RNA primer and DNA nucleotide. A bond is formed between this RNA primer and this new nucleotide. So what is happening here? First primer was formed, and to this primer now DNA nucleotides are being attached. For example, this is the primer. To this primer now nucleotides, DNA nucleotide. This is one DNA nucleotide which is attached. Now to this DNA nucleotide, again nucleotide, DNA nucleotide is attached. Again DNA nucleotide is attached. So like this, a chain will be formed. So to this RNA primer, new DNA nucleotides are attached. How they are attached? To this third carbon, on this third carbon, third free carbon of RNA nucleotide, that is RNA primer, OH group is there. So this OH group, which is on the third carbon, and the fifth, that is phosphate group, which is on the fifth carbon. Okay, so these two will join together and form a bond. Now this RNA and DNA are joined together. So RNA nucleotide and this DNA nucleotide is joined together, and to this DNA nucleotide one more DNA nucleotide will be there. So like this a long chain will be formed. So after activation of nucleotides, the DNA will open up. After DNA opens up, a primer is formed, and to this primer new DNA nucleotides are attached. To this primer new DNA nucleotides are attached. Okay, so now where will be the primer will be attached first? See here, this was the helix. After the helix has been opened up, now here this is the 3 carbon and this is the 5 carbon, that is 3 prime end and this is the 5 prime end. To this 3 prime end, here RNA primer will be attached. Here RNA primer will be attached. Okay, so if this is 3 prime end, so now if the strand is, if this parent strand is from 3 prime to 5 prime, this I am taking. If this strand, which is template strand, okay, which is the parental strand, so if this strand is there, so the polarity is 3 prime to 5 prime. Now on this, now a new strand will be formed. I am saying you, one new strand will be formed on this. Okay, one new strand will be formed here, one new strand will be formed here. So like this, how many? 2 will be formed. So when the new strand is formed here, when the new strand is formed now here, it will have, it will start from 5 dash to 3 dash. So here new strand is formed. New strand is formed from this space, okay, opened up space. So now if the polarity here is 3 prime now, then the new strand will start from 5 prime and goes, that is grows till 3 prime. So here this is the old template, which is 3 prime to 5 prime. Now new strand will be from 5 prime to 3 prime. So this is 5 prime and this will be your 3 prime. So the new strand will always grow from 5 prime to 3 prime. New strand will always grow from 5 prime to 3 prime. Okay, complementary strands always grows from 5 prime to 3 prime. Okay, the direction is from 5 prime to 3 prime. And why this is, why it is added at this third carbon? Why it starts at this third carbon? Because at this third carbon, one OH group will be there. It is at this third carbon. Now, if I see this one, this is the primer and this is the new DNA nucleotide. So it is always attached at third carbon only. If new DNA nucleotide is going to be attached to this RNA primer, it will be always at the 3 prime end. This is the primer and this is the new DNA nucleotide. If this new DNA nucleotide has to be attached to this RNA primer, it should always be, this attachment of this new nucleotide always should be at the 3 prime end, because at 3 prime, that is at the third, sorry, not 3 prime end, it should be at the third carbon, because on third carbon there is an OH group. What I am trying to tell you is, after the activation of the nucleotides takes place, DNA will open up. Okay, after opening of DNA, when the DNA is opening up, simultaneously RNA primer formation is taking place. So after the primer is formed, now the next step is attachment of this DNA nucleotides to this primer. Why DNA is attached to this RNA? Why this, no, it is not a sequence of DNA? Because the time which is taken for the formation of this bond is very less when in between DNA and RNA. So that is why it is taken, because as soon as it is opened, na, it has to form the bonds. As soon as the strand is opened, it has to form the bonds. New strand has to be formed, so it should be very quick. So that is why within less time RNA will bond. So that is why the primer is made up of RNA. Okay, and the third thing is, after RNA is, the primer is formed, new DNA nucleotides will be attached. And where will this new DNA nucleotides will attach? It will always attach to the third carbon, which is free. Here third carbon will be free now. At this free third carbon, they have an OH group. They have an OH group, and to this OH group, new DNA nucleotide will attach, thereby forming a bond. How they will attach? By the formation of this bond. This bond is nothing but phosphodiester bond. Phosphodiester bond. So here, because this DNA primer will have this 5 prime carbon free, and this is the OH. So between OH and the phosphate, bond formation will take place, and this new DNA will be attached to the RNA. New DNA will be attached to the RNA. So activation of nucleotides, opening of the DNA strand, RNA primer formation. After RNA primer formation, new DNA nucleotides are attached to the RNA primer. New DNA nucleotides are attached to the RNA primer. So this was about the third step. This was about the third step. Next step will be the actual replication. Next step will be the actual DNA replication, which we will see in the next video.